Hello, welcome back to the Ironside. Paul Nevin has left his role as first team coach at West Ham to join Strasbourg, which seems a bit of a backward step, if you ask me. But I'm going to dive into that and talk a little bit about what's going on regarding the coaches and the backroom staff at West Ham. But before we do that, if you haven't already, guys, please subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to like the video and also drop a comment down below. And yeah, let's get into it. Let's dissect West Ham. So, as you all would have read today, you would have seen the news that Paul Nevin, did I say Pat Nevin? I might have said Pat Nevin. I mean Paul Nevin. Paul Nevin, the first team coach of West Ham, or the former first team coach of West Ham, has left the club by mutual consent. Now, if this was an isolated incident, I wouldn't be too worried. But we had Warburton step down a week after the Europa League conference final. We've now got Paul Nevin stepping down. That is two of the key figures in our backroom staff stepping away from their roles for different reasons. Now, it's understood that Paul Nevin has stepped away from West Ham, mutual consent, in order to chase other... What was it that I read? New challenges outside the Premier League. So what I've read and what I've found out is that he is likely to join up with Patrick Vieira at Strasbourg, which is a French team. I don't see any links with Patrick Vieira other than maybe he aligns himself with the football that Vieira wants to play, so maybe he's more in tune with that. But the reason I'm doing this video and the reason I wanted to get this one out, mainly outside of transfers, because there's diddly squat happening for us at the minute, but it is a little bit worrying. If you look at the calibre of staff we've had leave over the past 12 months, we had Stuart Pearce jump ship at the end of last season. Very unexpected. No one would have predicted that. He was a mainstay and a very big voice in that dressing room. Then you had Warburton step down. I wasn't a massive fan. I don't think many people were. I think a lot of people blamed him for our style of football and therefore lack of this season. He stepped away. And now we've got Paul Nevin stepping away. Now, I know we've just had Tim Steiden, whatever his name is, come in. But he's obviously not part of the coaching team. So I'm a little bit worried as to why we're losing our coaches. Is it the rats jumping leaving a sinking ship? Or is there nothing really to it? They're just doing what they're saying, going on to seek different avenues. My thoughts are that there's two reasons why these guys are leaving. And it's one of two. It's their ambitions don't align with David Moyes. So they don't believe in maybe what David Moyes sees the club doing, don't believe in the way he's playing football, and don't believe the club can achieve what they want under his guidance. Or alternatively, there is a breakdown in communication when it comes to tactics. Now, I believe at the back end of last season, there was a bit of a change-up in who managed what roles at West Ham. David Moyes wanted to be a lot more hands-on, so he removed certain figures from certain tactics and certain coaching drills so he could oversee them himself. Now, if that's true, that's extremely worrying, because it's no secret that our football this year was a whole load worse than what it was last season. We didn't have anything for large parts of the season to cause most teams in the league problems. Now, I know it's only July, and I don't want to be a pessimist, and I don't want to piss on everyone's brigade after the massive high we had in Prague a few weeks ago. But I'm getting extremely worried with the state of our football club at the minute. I think I'm panicking like a lot of people are, but I see it just seems that there wasn't a replacement for Rice. There's not a replacement for Rice, which is dreadful, which we all had a inkling might be the case, but we hoped for more. That's dreadful planning. I don't care how you paint it. We knew he was leaving 18 months ago. Why have we not got anyone in place? We're linked with 4, 5, 6 names and they're changing daily. I'm hoping I'm wrong and there is someone lined up that we're just going to see come in, but it doesn't look like it. Warburton, first team coach, left 3 weeks ago. We've not even been linked with any names to replace him. We just had Paul Nevin walk away. Again, no names to come in and replace him. Now, I'm not hoping. I don't know if this is something to do with Stuyten. I can't even say his name, but we're just going to call him Timmy. I don't know if it's to do with Timmy and what he wants moving forward, or if it's the board and they're trying to get in maybe a team of coaches that align more with their ambitions and what they want to do. If that's the case, then I wouldn't be surprised to see Nolan walk away in the coming weeks and then followed shortly by David Moyes, which, as much as I'm not a fan of the football we've been playing the last probably 18 months, as I'm not a fan of a lot of Moyes' tactics, I don't want us to get rid of him now. If we were going to get rid of him, we needed to do it after the Europa Conference League final. So he had the whole summer. He's still on holiday now, so he hasn't actually started pre-season. Pre-season was due to start today. So they backed the manager. They've stuck with him. They have to stick with him now moving forward. So I'm hoping that's not the case. But if it is the case, I'm hoping there's a lot of wishful thinking and hoping here. I'm hoping that they have a team that they want to come in. There's still decent managers and decent coaches out there that could definitely join our setup. I said it as soon as he was sacked by Bournemouth, but I wanted us to go out and get Gary O'Neill in to replace Warburton. He worked wonders at Bournemouth last year, and it might have been a flash in the pan. It might not be. He might not have anything really there, but based off of the wonders that he performed at Bournemouth last year, it seems like a no-brainer. He's still out of work. He's got links with the club. He knows the Premier League. It seems silly to me to not even approach him and see if he'd want to take a background staff role rather than being the main figure. But then there needs to be decisions made in the next couple of weeks. Things need to start happening quickly. We need to get in at least one more coach. We then need to start buying players. I'm not going to talk about transfers too much in this. But old Timmy is on the blower constantly looking for deals. He's linked with everyone. We're linked with everyone like we are every season. But we apparently don't have any budget. We're waiting on the Rice money to clear, which is complete bollocks. We have money. It's just whether he wants to spend it, to be honest. I'm not too sure where Kretinsky stands in all this, because he seems to be a silent partner. We never hear from him. We never see him. We never really do anything, but he is going to be our money man. So there's... like I said, I don't want to be pessimistic and I don't want to be the bearer of bad news and I don't want to come in here and be all downbeat, but I'm just saying it how it is. There's massive change in the staff and the club this year. There's rumours that we have 6 or 7 players that are unhappy, and you can't blame them. Like, the football that we played was... I know we won a European trophy, I know that. But the football we played was dire at times. So why would you have the calibre of Paquetá, Scamacca, Benrahma, all those type of players, them flair players, why would they want to stay at a club that aren't allowing them to go out and do what they do best, which is be those flair players, be those players to beat someone, to create something out of nothing? Moyes stifles that quite a lot. So I can see why they're unhappy. So unless Moyes changes his mindset towards these players, I can see it ending badly for a lot of these exciting players that we have. If you look at the track record of Moyes managing them, it's never really worked out too well for him, or the players for that matter. Now, that being said, I am, you have to be behind the manager to a certain degree because he's leading our club out. So I'm behind him in the sense of I want him to do well, I don't want him to fail. And I'm hoping that what we saw towards the latter end of the season, so the last probably 3 to 5 weeks where we started to put in together better performances, that's the team we're going to see next year. But again, saying that, you're going to have 2 new coaches come in, and I don't know if they're wanting to bring 2 coaches in to help Moyes find a new way, or if to come in and just fall in line behind Moyes. If it's the latter, then we're in a worrying place. If it's the former, then great. That's perfect. Because for all I know, the board might have seen this season and been like, right, we need to change the backroom staff because the football wasn't good enough. Get rid of Warburton because he was the last one in. And we'll get rid of Nevin because he's been with Moyes for 3 years. He's been with us for 3 years. So everything that we've done positively, Nevin's been there. And so has David Moyes. So it's an interesting one to see where we're going to go from here. I don't know if old Timmy will have any say in the coaching staff, to be honest. I'm not too sure exactly how hands-on his role will be and how much we'll see of him. But we're linked to a load of players here, there and everywhere. Again, in the next couple of weeks, you're going to see some actual deals going through across the Premier League. That's because everyone's coming back from their summer holidays. I alluded to this in my previous video. I'm going to be bringing out another scout report of who we're going to be looking at. I'm going to be doing that in the next week or so. I don't like to say days because time gets away with you. And yeah, but that is it for today, guys. It was just a quick one just to talk about Paul Nevin leaving and my thoughts as to why he might be leaving. Well, we know why he's leaving. He's going to join Patrick Vieira because I think he believes in him more. Maybe it's a different challenge, but is it as much of a challenge going to the French league, which has just dropped out of Europe's top five leagues? I'd argue the championship's more competitive. But what do you guys think? Why do you think our coaches are leaving? What are you expecting from this season? I'm quite low in my expectations at the minute, but that's because it's the beginning of the summer and all we've seen is outgoings. We've lost Declan Rice. We've lost two of our coaches and we bought in. I'm going to be honest, I don't know anything about Timmy. What I do know is what I found out after we were linked with bringing him in. Doesn't mean anything to me, really. It's all just words on paper. But what do you guys think? Do you think Nolan's next out the door? Do you think Nolan's going to stick it? Who are you going to replace him with? Let me know what you guys think down in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. And until the next time, come on, you Irons.